And the way search depends on how the index and ranks are represented is through the outputs. So the crawl web procedure outputs two things, an index and a ranks list. Both of those are represented as dictionaries. The index maps a keyword to a list of URLs, and the ranks maps a URL to its rank score. In the search module, a procedure like Lucky Search depends on getting both of those things as inputs. So this is quite a complex dependency, and this is the kind of thing that makes it much harder to maintain code, it makes it much harder to understand code, and it makes it much harder to change the code. If we decide to change something about the crawler, well, we've got to worry about all these procedures in search that use these outputs. So our goal is to hide all that complexity. In general, the way we hide things is to use abstraction. Abstraction is about hiding details. Our goal is to find a way to restructure the code so we don't need to know all those details. And that's a form of abstraction. Abstraction is all about hiding details. What we want is an abstract object that the crawler creates that has the properties search needs to be able to do its work, but without search requiring to know the details of how that's represented. So our goal is to replace all this with one abstract object. We'll call that a web corpus. And that will be the output of the crawler and the input to the search. And we'll end up defining this web corpus object in a new module. What this is actually a new type. And Python provides a way to define new types. They're called classes. Before we get into how to create our own type, like the web corpus type that we need here, we're going to step back and learn more about how types work in Python.